Hello, this is Harry Norman for Proactive Investors, and welcome to another Proactive Audio interview. Today is Tuesday, the 14th of June 2011, and I'm talking with David Fowler, Director and CEO of Orosur Mining, listed on the AIM market mining sector. Stock ticker OMI, share price 68 pence, market cap £44.4 million. Orosur Mining is also listed on the TSX Venture Exchange. Web address Orosur, O-R-O-S-U-R, orosur.ca. David, thank you very much for joining us for this interview.
Thanks, Harry. Pleased to join you.
Please give investors a brief introduction to Orosur Mining and the company's business strategy.
Orosur is listed on both the TSXV and the AIM market in London. We are a gold company focused on South America. We have one producing asset, the gold mine in Uruguay, which last year produced 55,000 ounces of gold. We also have exploration and development projects focused on gold in Chile and Uruguay. The objective of the company is to grow our production profile through development of our existing projects and through acquisition.
Orosur Mining has been focused on reducing production costs at the San Gregorio gold mine in Uruguay since 2009. The target for the year to the end of May was to produce 55,000 ounces of gold at an average cost of $825 per ounce, and the cost target was later revised downwards to $750 per ounce. So, how did you get on, David?
I'm really pleased to confirm that our production for the full year was 55,800 ounces of gold, which was above our target of 55,000 ounces of production. Also, importantly from us, we have reduced our cash cost target from $825 per ounce down to $750 per ounce for the full year. Whilst we have not finished our final audited accounts, I believe that the cash cost per ounce will be very close to this target. When you consider that there has been significant increases in fuel prices this year and appreciation of the Uruguayan currency, I think it's been a very solid year for the company.
So how did you achieve these cost reductions, and what is the scope for further cost reductions, David?
We have worked hard to reduce cash costs this year and have had some help from higher silver byproduct credits. Some of the key areas that we're focused on have been in-house maintenance, contractor negotiations, a reduction in people, and increased productivity, and these have all made important contributions. Going forward, we believe that we can reduce cash costs further within 1 to 2 years. This will be achieved by the development of our underground operation, Arenal Deeps. Arenal Deeps will have higher head grades and therefore allow us to reduce our cash costs to something like $600 per ounce within a couple of years.
Do you see the Sobre Salente project as a possible way to extend the life of mine at San Gregorio?
Sobre Salente has been a focus of our near mine exploration efforts over the last 6 months, and we have completed something like 9,000 metres of drilling. We currently have an independent consultant preparing an updated 43-101 resource on the project, and we would expect that to be released in the coming months by the end of August 2011. Interestingly, a number of the deeper holes had good high-grade mineralized intercepts, so we are targeting a new round of drilling in the coming year to try and extend the resource base. There are also a number of similar targets around Sobre Saliente that we will be drilling in the coming year also.
Last Friday, you announced that Orosur is acquiring the Talca Gold Exploration and Development Project in Chile. What is compelling about the Talca project, and what are the terms of this acquisition?
Talca is a well-known high-grade artisanal mine, approximately 375 kilometres north of Santiago. It has produced something in the order of 300,000 ounces over a 40-year period on a relatively small scale, something like 10,000 to 15,000 ounces of production per year. Production has recently been halted, and we will now focus on exploration on the project to try and develop a project with a more significant scale. There has been no historical drilling, and we see excellent near-mine exploration targets and district exploration upside with existing veins and shear structures open along strike and down dip. We plan to start drilling within 3 months, and we expect to define our first NI 43-101 resource within 12 months. Given that the mine recently operated on a small scale, we will target the rapid completion of a feasibility study and production. We will pay $4 million over 12 months to earn a 25% interest in the project. We will then have 5 years to complete the feasibility study, and on the completion of the feasibility study, we'll have to pay another $4 million to acquire the project with a final 1% NSR royalty paid once production commences.
What's happening with your other Chilean projects, Pantaneo, which already has a resource of 1 million ounces of gold, and Anillo, which is an earlier stage project?
Pantaneo is in the Maricunga belt of Chile, a very well-known gold district in Chile with something like 60 million ounces of gold defined in some fairly large projects. Kinross has two producing mines in the district. Our resource, which is smaller than some of these other deposits, has something in the order of 1 million ounces defined to date in oxide and mixed resources. We have commenced a scoping study and are in the process of completing metallurgical test work with the target of being able to develop a run-of-mine heap leach project at the operation or at the project. Anillo is further north than Antofagasta. It is an early stage exploration project near the El Peñon mine, which currently produces in the order of 400,000 ounces per annum from high grade gold and silver veins and is operated by Yamana Gold. We have identified a number of targets adjacent to a recent discovery by Yamana called Veta Victoria, which is near El Peñon, and have completed one round of shallow drilling during 2011. These results are encouraging, and we are now returning to drill deeper holes, something like 4,500 metres, which will commence in June 2011.
You have various other assets in Uruguay, some of which you retain control of and some of which you have optioned to other companies. Please would you talk us through your other assets in Uruguay, David?
We have a number of gold projects in Uruguay where we continue to do exploration and we'll be targeting drilling in the coming 6 months. As we've continued to focus on gold, we've looked to farm out our non-gold assets. We have four joint venture projects with Olivet Resources on diamonds, Gladiator Resources on iron ore, and two other groups with gold and base metals. The iron ore at this stage looks the most promising. We have a 20% free carried interest, with Gladiator earning an 80% interest in the project. We expect them to release their first resource announcement in the coming months and move quickly towards pre-feasibility later this year or early next year. As a result of the success they've had over the last 12 months on the project, their market cap has risen from $5 million to $30 million, and we would expect there to be further increases going forward as they move closer towards feasibility.
On Friday last, you raised $13.5 million US, which is about £8.3 million sterling, with a share placing. Where does this leave Orosur Mining's financial situation going forward?
The equity raising was to fund Elka and target new growth. We had $14 million cash on hand at the 31st of May 2011, and we believe that we can fund existing investment in the R&L Deeps and the completion of the tailings facility and our ongoing exploration in Uruguay from cash flow from operations. So the company is very well positioned to be able to pursue growth and complete its plans over the coming 12 months.
What can investors expect from Orosur Mining over the next 12 to 18 months?
In the coming financial year, we're targeting a very similar operating performance, something like 55,000 to 60,000 ounces, which will largely come from open pit. R&L Deeps project we have commenced development on will only make a smallish contribution to production this year, something like 17,000 ounces, but it will be an important year as our capital is invested and we set ourselves up for higher production levels in the coming years. On the exploration and development front, we have a number of drill programs which will be happening in the course of the current year, particularly at Anillo and our new project Telca, and then the other areas that we'll be focusing on in Uruguay.
Who are Orosur Mining's major shareholders and how supportive are they, David?
We have a mix of institutional shareholders and private clients who together make up approximately 40% of the shareholder base. Those institutions and private clients are really split between the UK, Canada and the US. I believe the shareholders have been very supportive over the last period of time and a number of them have participated in the equity raising we completed last week and support the company's plans.
What are your thoughts on the way the market currently values Orosur Mining?
I think the market gives us very little value for our exploration and development potential. I see further potential to extend the mine life at San Gregorio, and we have a very active exploration program this year, which has the potential to deliver significant increases in value. So overall, I think we're being valued on a small multiple of our current cash flow, and I think there's significant scope for further appreciation in the share price.
Remember, Proactive Investors is not an investment advice service. Make sure you register at proactiveinvestors.co.uk or proactiveinvestors.com for our weekly newsletter, which will keep you informed about our articles, interviews, and events. Thank you for listening.